How are you doing? Hi, I'm Riyadh. Welcome back to my channel. What's going on? Every so often, because of this channel, I get the chance to go and do something absolutely mental. Something that is on my bucket list, something that I never would have been able to do before I started this channel. Just something crazy. One of those things happened at the weekend just gone. I was given the chance to go and watch the rehearsal of Titanic Live at the Royal Albert Hall here in London. Okay, what is Titanic Live, I hear you ask? It's essentially where they play the movie on a big screen, they remove the music that's normally in the film, and instead they've got a live orchestra, a choir, an opera singer, all performing what was actually in the movie, but this time live in front of you. I may have emailed them and poached them and asked them for the opportunity, but hey, I still got to go. And just to give you a little bit of context on how big this film is in my life, and how big this score is in my life. Titanic came out in 1997 when I was 6 years old. I begged my mom to bring me to the cinema. I was a good 6 years too young to go and see the film, which was rated 12. Mom still tried to sneak me into the cinema. They turned us away.
I can't even describe how much Riyadh loved Titanic. I remember years ago we got the VHS when he was about 6 or 7.
Wait, some people won't know what VHS is.
You can own the adventure of a lifetime. Titanic. On video cassette.
And from that moment on, that film was etched into my mind as my number one all-time favorite. I then started to collect Titanic books on the history of the boat, the sinking, the White Star Line. I collected prints of the original White Star Line advertisements for tickets on Titanic, copies of the front page of the New York Times on April 15th, 1912, the day after the sinking. I went to visit Cove in County Cork, the last docking spot of the Titanic before it went out into the Atlantic. I also went to the museum and shipyard where Titanic was built in Belfast. And if you do the maths, I watched the film about 5 or 6 times a year since 1997 until now, which means I've watched it over 100 times. I'm a loser. But the one thing I really wanted to do was to see James Horner's score performed live in front of me, and I've never ever had that opportunity, so this was massive for me. So Mom and I hopped in the car on our way to the Royal Albert Hall.
So yeah, we're on our way there now. What else
God,
did I have to say?
You're super excited, aren't you?
Yeah.
You're on nerves.
I'm sweating actually.
Yeah.
I'll let Mom describe the issue I've had with boyfriends and dating guys and the film Titanic.
All the boyfriends that I used to bring home would have to sit through the whole movie.
Yeah. There, not one guy
he
that I've dated.
Fed them Titanic on the first.
But it's a test.
Date.
You know, you've got a test to make sure that they're the one. Or my test is if you can stay up through Titanic without wanting to have or falling asleep, then you're a special kind of guy.
So we arrive at the Royal Albert Hall.
God himself could not sink this ship.
And I find the exact step, the exact spot where James Horner stood about 2 or 3 years ago when they were showing the film in the venue the last time.
This is it. This is the bit. So James Horner was stood here when for that big premiere that happened. And they interviewed him. I think, wait, maybe it was here. I don't know. I'll bring it. Here's the clip now.
I'm now joined by the Oscar-winning composer of the score of Titanic, Mr. James Horner. Hello, good afternoon. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
This is like a piece of history right now. This is a piece of history. This is actually happening. Is this happening? It's happening.
We made our way into the stage door, collected our wristbands, and then slowly worked our way into the backstage of the Royal Albert Hall.
What did he say?
I don't know. I don't know where to go.
Can I just point out that at this stage we are lost as
arena?
And that is when I hear the very gentle, very subtle, yet very powerful, distinctive sound of the Titanic score.
Oh! Encouraging.
Wait, wait, do you hear that? Oh my god. Oh my god. I don't know if I'm allowed here.
Look at me when I'm talking to you!
Literally losing my shit.
This is Jack, lovely Jack, bringing us in.
Nice to meet you.
Thanks for the access, Jack. So they're rehearsing right now, are they?
Yeah.
We've got to keep our voice down. Okay, thank you.
Mr. Andrews!
The mic!
I now sing.
Now, as you can imagine, I'm extremely restricted with what I can show you from inside the auditorium, what I shot, but I'm just going to put together a couple of quick bits, but in particular this, my favourite, my most emotional, my just... Finally, this.
Take them down! Keep it steady! Sides together, steady! Keep it steady!
And if that wasn't enough, we were then brought backstage into the dressing room of the conductor, Ludwig Wicki. Inside, I was fangirling hard, but I kept it together.
Hello!
Hi, you're Ludwig!
I'm Ludwig.
Nice to meet you. This is a beautiful dressing room, by the way.
I like it.
Very glamorous.
Yeah, and I was here with many composers, with James Horner.
Have you met James?
Yeah, he was here. On the... That's his...
No!
His signature. He signed my score.
James Horner himself.
That's James Horner himself, yeah.
Wow. What was he like as a man?
He was very tender, very quiet, very shy.
Yeah.
It was... Beautiful human.
It's almost at odds with the type of music that he makes, which is so powerful and so punchy. The film itself, do you have a special version of the film without the orchestra pieces, or are you playing over what's already in the film?
No. It's nothing coming from the film. Music is all live.
All live?
Yeah, sure.
So you have a very special version of the film that's been stripped back.
Yeah.
That's incredible. Music. Well, you are busy. You've got two shows to do today.
Yeah.
One in an hour or two, and then the one that we're coming to, we're going to be at the evening show.
Yeah. Cool. Come
back. It was
backstage,
lovely to meet you.
Yeah. Same night.
Thank you, Ludwig.
Come backstage.
Oh, I'd like to. See you later.
Bye.
So then Mom and I left. We dried off our tears. We got ready, looking sexy for the big performance, went back to the Royal Albert Hall. The place was absolutely packed, completely sold out show, where I meet my alcoholic best friend who's coming with us.
Double vodka gin. You're not recording, are you?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
This is Potty, you know Potty, my bestie.
Who is this?
Fake news. Fake news, delete your account.
There was also someone who had never seen someone vlog before. As a YouTuber, this is what we experience every day. That face is literally the face of anyone in public that you walk past if you're talking to a camera. Every single person. Then the show started, we're sitting right in the center, the best seats in the house. At At the end, there was a massive standing ovation. People were clapping for about 2 or 3 minutes. It was incredible. So a massive, massive, from the bottom of my heart, thank you to the Royal Albert Hall and the Royal Philharmonic Concert Orchestra for making one of my bucket list dreams come true and creating lifelong memories. I will never, ever, ever forget that day. I know there are a couple of dates left on the Titanic Live Tour if you want to see if it's near where you live or if you want to travel there. The link to that is down below, and also the Royal Albert Hall. They're constantly doing movie nights like this if you're into that kind of thing. Thank you for putting up with my fangirling. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in a couple of days, won't I? Big love. See you later. Bye.
Hello, it's recording. This is me, Polly, Riyadh, flatmate, and best friend. So if you ever come near him, I'm going to kill you.
What are you doing?
I'm vlogging myself.